So when we think about how to train neural networks, what do you need to know about, say, backpropagation? Well, one thing you don't need to know about backprop is how to implement it. That's one of the brilliant things that TensorFlow does for us, is it takes the internals of backpropagation and does that all for us underneath the hood. But there are some important things to know. The first is that backprop really does rely on this idea of gradients. Things need to be differentiable for us to be able to learn on them. One or two small discontinuities in our various functions are fine, but in general, we need differentiable functions to be able to learn with neural nets. Another thing is that gradients can vanish. If our networks get too deep, sort of signal-to-noise ratios get bad as you go further and further down the model, and learning can really become quite slow. ReLUs can be useful there. There are also some other strategies that we won't talk about in this class. But in general, you do want to think about limiting the depth of your model to sort of the minimum effective depth if you can. It's also important to know that gradients can explode. If our learning rates are too high, we get these sort of crazy instabilities, we can get NANs in our model. The thing to do there is to try again with a lower learning rate. Last thing to know is that ReLUs can die. It's possible that because we have this hard cap at zero, if we end up with everything below that value of zero, then there's no way for gradients to get propagated back through, and we'll never be able to pull ourselves back up into the land of living ReLU layers. So keep an eye out for those. And again, try again with a different initialization or a lower learning rate. At training time, it's often very useful for us to have normalized feature values when they come in. If things are on roughly the same scale, this can help speed the convergence of neural nets. So the exact value of the scale doesn't really matter. We often recommend -1 to +1 as an approximate range. It could be -5 to +5 or -0 to 1. It doesn't really matter so long as all of our inputs are on roughly the same scale. Finally, one last trick that's useful in training deep networks is the idea of an additional form of regularization that is called dropout. And dropout is kind of a funny idea. When we apply dropout, what we're saying is that with probability p, we take a node and we essentially remove it from the network for a single gradient step. On different gradient steps, we repeat and we'll take different nodes to drop out randomly. So the more you drop out, the stronger regularization you have. And you can kind of see this clearly, where if you drop everything out, you have an extremely simple model that is essentially useless. If you drop out nothing, you allow the model to have its full complexity. And if you have dropout somewhere in the middle, you're applying some sort of useful regularization there. Dropout is one of the key advances that has enabled a number of the strong results that we've gotten recently that has pushed deep learning to the forefront.